In this video, I'm visiting the remains of uranium mineshaft number 277, belonging to the Zobes uranium deposit, located in the Vogtland region of Germany, between the small towns of Zobes and Mechelgrün. This vein type deposit, being the second largest in Saxony, was mined from 1949 to roughly 1963. And subsequent exploration work continued into the 1970s. With a total yield of about 4.7 thousand tons of uranium, this deposit was responsible for 80% of all uranium that was mined in the Vogtland region, followed by the Schneckenstein deposit, responsible for merely 16%. The composition of uranium ore veins found at this location can be grouped into three different types. The oldest and rarest form is the quartz pitchblende carbonate variation, followed by the slightly more common bismuth cobalt nickel uranium formation. And lastly, the youngest and most common vein type consisting of quartz, uraninite and hematite. Most of the mineralization was mined at a depth of between 200 and 650 meters. The uranium ore was found in form of primary uraninite, accompanied by secondary uranium formations and uranschwärze, which is a powdery mixture of uraninite and clay. The high-grade ore was shipped directly to the Soviet Union, where it was used for the construction of nuclear weapons in the ongoing arms race with the United States of America. As you can see, the site is pretty run down and littered with trash. Recultivation work started directly after the mining activities came to an end. The shaft was filled with overburden material from the large conical spoil heaps. This is my red eyes alarm going off because of elevated readings caused by an intense hotspot that somebody partially excavated, covered with worn out tires. Spectroscopic analysis confirms radium-226 daughter nuclides, which are to be expected when natural uranium is present. The readings at the bottom of this hole are quite high, due to the presence of a multitude of sources, and also due to the geometry, irradiating the detector from multiple sides at the same time. I was kinda curious to see if one could find uraninite there, standing out against the extreme background. Thank you. But as expected, the sum of all sources combined is far greater than any individual source itself in terms of the dose rate. I also don't recommend digging in this hole for extended periods of time, because the received dose will be much higher than with standard point sources. I suppose this is the shaft itself, covered with a concrete slab that is also bolted down. Nearby, you can find some spoil material, with the occasional hotspot in between. This looks like garbage. Slightly more interesting, but we can still improve. Here we are at the edge of the former conical spoil heaps, and this sounds a little bit more potent than before. Thank you. Not yet the jackpot I was hoping for. This hotspot felt different, if that makes any sense. If you see the readings increasing with depth, that's always a good sign.
Holy moly.
I feel like the guys who pulled Saddam Hussein out of the hole. Where is Paul Bremer when you need him?
Alter Falter. Jesus Maria.
More radioactive doesn't necessarily equal more beautiful, but with pitchblende, aka uraninite, there is certainly a connection. Not too far away, I found this location, where somebody smashed a larger chunk into pieces. The fragments are slightly radioactive, with pyrite and some secondary uranium formations. After crossing the stream, we reach some more ruins on our way back to the car. It's about time we take a closer look at our findings. Here you can see how the area around shaft 277 has changed over the years. For this example, I used two different images, one contemporary satellite image and one from 1965, shortly after the mining activities had stopped.